The size advantage goes the way of Zamboanga. Experience goes the way of Yamaguchi. Look for the right hand of Yamaguchi. Look for the submissions. Lots of instructions early on from Yamaguchi's corner.
Zamboanga is a rising star, and she's got the swagger of an undefeated athlete, but Yamaguchi is used to taking the shine off of stars and putting people down a couple of pegs.
Yamaguchi had two of the all-time great matches against world champion Angela Lee. She'd love a trilogy match. Let's see how she handles an up-and-comer in Denice Zamboanga. Zamboanga, double jab, right hand, beautifully executed down the pipe. Mei, nice tuck under, looks for a takedown. Zamboanga threads a high knee and backs her against the circle wall. Crossing elbow from the Filipina, elbow there from the Japanese athlete, and a knee from Zamboanga. Aggressive start from both these ladies. Knees to the inside thigh there from Yamaguchi. Palm heel strike from Zamboanga. I like it on the inside, not utilized enough. Good knee to the waist there from Zamboanga. And the corking knees to the inside thigh from Yamaguchi. Mitch once again in this most heated atomweight division in which Angela Lee is still the champion, still unbeaten. How important is this bout?
I think this match is extremely important. Other than your favorite, Stamp Fairtex, who you think deserves a shot because she's a two-sport queen, I think this right here is an extremely important matchup to determine who truly could be the next contender for the atomweight title. Good control right now from Zamboanga, pressing her up against that circle wall. And she did a beautiful job of stopping the first initial takedown attempt of Yamaguchi.
Zamboanga edges forward. Yamaguchi skip up inside thigh kick. The Mawashi Getty, the roundhouse kick of the Karateka. Good jab there. Jab two, counter right hand from Yamaguchi, circles off counterclockwise. There's the overhand right I spoke about earlier. Yamaguchi loves to throw it. Jab from Zamboanga, using the lead hand well so far. Another jab two from the Filipina. Just gauging her distance. Good cutting leg kick there from Yamaguchi. Range finding with the lead hand, Yamaguchi. Counter strikes there from Zamboanga. Yamaguchi has seen it all in her career, threads the overhand right again, didn't quite turn the knuckles in. Zamboanga comes forward, needs to commit. Yamaguchi wants to take her down. Zamboanga may end up in top position, indeed just does that. Well done from Zamboanga, and let's see what she can do on the floor against a BJJ black belt.
Zamboanga has beautiful takedown defense. The way she's able to frame with her forearms to stop that oncoming pressure of Yamaguchi is beautiful. Now you can see Yamaguchi's trying to suck in that leg. She's trying to turn the corner and attack that single leg, trying to trip her down. But Zamboanga's doing a good job of maintaining that base and her balance to maintain that top position. Heavy sprawl right now coming from Zamboanga as Mei Yamaguchi works her way back up to her feet.
Mitch, it wasn't so long ago that the majority of our Philippines athletes had a reputation as not being great grapplers, especially great wrestlers, and how those times have changed now. We're seeing it here from Denice Zamboanga. We saw it earlier in the night from Honorio Benario. We see it from the likes of Joshua Pascio, Kevin Ballignon, Danny Kingad. They've changed over the last 2 years, the Philippines athletes.
Mixed martial arts in the Philippines is the real deal, Michael Cervello. You are seeing top-tier athletes really well round out their skill set and put things together like this anti-wrestling that we're seeing right now from Zamboanga.
Take you on a deep Jules featherweight world champion, a Valkyrie featherweight champion, a Pan-American Asian and Japanese national BJJ gold medalist. Mei Yamaguchi, 21-11-1, 9 submission wins. Right hand from Yamaguchi, drifts off to her left. Zamboanga goes with a jab, goes the right hand of her own to the orbital. and drifts out of the way of the right hand. The right power side is Yamaguchi. Nice duck under. Counter right hand. Eats a right to the nose. There's a right to the jaw from Zamboanga. Denice Zamboanga showing why she's called the Menace.
Good forward pressure coming from Zamboanga, always cutting the angles. You can see the little subtle changes in footwork just to keep her.
Stanza was superb, and again she opens up with that beautiful down the line jab. Yamaguchi, Mawashi Geri trying to loop the shin up to the neck of Zamboanga. Zamboanga jab again, no right hand behind it though. There's a jab from Yamaguchi. She'll try for the jab overhand right if she gets close enough. Long arms on Zamboanga, trying to keep Yamaguchi at bay by putting that jab in the face of the Japanese athlete.
Zamboanga smiled and gave her a couple of the eyebrows. Mei Yamaguchi, we got to keep in mind that, you know, Denice Zamboanga is the main training partner of the two-sport queen, Stamp Fairtex. So she is definitely surrounded by some high-level athletes over there at Fairtex Training Center.
There's the overhand right from Yamaguchi. She threads it so well, and it comes agonizingly close.
But it's not just the overhand right. It's the way that she's gone for the counter shot. She throws that overhand right, and then a beautiful little roll just to evade the next punch.
There it is again, right hand to the jaw of Zamboanga. Mitch, in your opinion, who's winning the stand-up battle here?
In these past, you know, 2 minutes here have been pretty back and forth. But in the first, I think Zamboanga was able to touch her up a little bit more. But Mei is starting to find a home for that right hand.
Good right hand again for Yamaguchi. Zamboanga threads the jab. Yamaguchi, short elbow in the inside, throws the overhand right, goes counterclockwise. On the balls of her feet here, Yamaguchi. Some swelling under the right eye of Mei Yamaguchi. Now that is courtesy of the lead hand, the jab of Zamboanga. Zamboanga showing patience beyond her years. Fights very tall here, Zamboanga. Very straight up in her stance.
And I think that's why that overhand right has been able to touch her so often, because her head is propped up so high. If she tucks that chin a little bit, keeps her head a little bit more protected, it might not have that same sort of effect.
Zamboanga wants to stamp her authority in the center of the circle here. Halfway through the second round, halfway through the contest, driving takedown from Yamaguchi. Immediately, Zamboanga closes the guard. What does Mei look to do from here, Dragon?
That time, Mei Yamaguchi was able to set that takedown up. She landed a few overhand rights, and then she threw the overhand right and dropped down to change levels. And you saw that Zamboanga was caught up top and was able to be put on her back. Now Mei Yamaguchi's trying to posture up and expect her to maybe sit in this position for a little bit while. Just drop a little bit of the ground and pound, maybe posture up, start pushing down the legs and look to pass the guard. But Mei Yamaguchi's comfortable here to sit and ground and pound.
Yamaguchi, a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, does have 9 wins by submission out of 21 career victories, a 43% finishing rate via the subs. Has never been submitted, has never been knocked out. Close guard here from Zamboanga.
But Zamboanga is very active off her back. A lot of punching. Beautiful little sweep as Mei Yamaguchi falls into attack a heel. Looks like she's got an Achilles lock, trying to put a lot of pressure on that lower calf as Zamboanga tries to punch her way out.
What is the defense for Zamboanga here, Dragon?
You can see Zamboanga's got to keep her leg from being extended. She does it when she wants to crowd Mei Yamaguchi. She doesn't want to allow Mei Yamaguchi to stretch out and apply pressure to that Achilles. You can see she's trying to stay nice and tight, crouch, and cover up on Mei Yamaguchi and start throwing those hands.
Team Philippines are 1-1 so far here tonight. A win for Honorio Benario over Shannon Wirichai earlier on. And Zamboanga defeat Mei Yamaguchi.
Mei Yamaguchi might be trying to go for a heel hook now. You can see it's important for Zamboanga to keep her foot on the floor. She doesn't want to allow Mei Yamaguchi to pop it up like she's doing right now and get control of that heel. She's got to try to peel those legs off and sit up into Mei Yamaguchi.
Yamaguchi hunting for a finish here in the second round. One of 4 Japanese competitors on tonight's card here in Singapore. We've also got the amazing Ayaka Miura, Yoshihiro Akiyama, Kimihiro Ito, all on our main card. Some Last flurry ground and pound here from Denice Zamboanga.
Good defense by Mei Yamaguchi to avoid a lot of those shots.
Been boxing beautifully. Yamaguchi's been using that overhand right she's renowned for. Good jab there from Zamboanga.
It's, like you said, it's that linear boxing. It's just that straight 1-2 at higher repetitions. Just throws it over and over.
Just to let you know, folks, we are now just 10 minutes away from the start of our main card. Five bouts for you in that one, including the double world title main events.
You can see how Mei Yamaguchi is trying to set these things up, how she set up that head kick. She looked like she was going to throw the overhand right. Threw that big head kick, didn't quite connect though, but then she changed levels. Zamboanga knows what's going on here. She's not falling for any of Mei Yamaguchi's tricks.
Zamboanga looks far more experienced than her record reflects, Dragon.
Young age, just 23 years old, you know, but she's got that swagger of an undefeated athlete coming in here with a skill set to match.
Yamaguchi, can she throw that overhand right, get on the inside of Zamboanga? Another two-punch combination down the corridor there from the Filipina. Do you think that Yamaguchi expected this to be on the ground a lot more than it has, Dragon?
I think she expected her takedowns to be more successful. I think she was confident in her wrestling, and she didn't think Zamboanga would give her this hard a time with the takedown defense. But, you know, she's doing a good job of trying to mix things up, but she's got to do something about these straight punches that are just coming with high volume.
Trying to get on the inside, close that distance. Mei Yamaguchi eats an uppercut. Zamboanga's hands looking on point here so far. Drifts off clockwise, threads the jab there to Yamaguchi. That right eye is swelling shut on Mei Yamaguchi. Two-punch combination, a little slip there from Mei.
Not a lot of kicks coming from Zamboanga, but staying with the tradition of those, you know, slick Filipino boxers. She is putting hands on Yamaguchi.
Double leg
sprawl there with the double underhooks to reverse the position.
Look at this from Zamboanga. How impressive is she? Curling left hand, corking knee from Zamboanga. Elbow on the inside from Zamboanga. Uppercut elbow from Zamboanga. This is impressive. Is it a performance like this that earns her a title shot, Mitch?
Man, if the last 2 minutes go the way that the, you know, the first 13 have gone, Zamboanga is putting together a pretty good performance. And I think she is just making my point, Michael Chiavello, that she deserves a crack at the atomweight queen, Angela Lee, with a performance like this. She's doing great.
Let's not write off Mei Yamaguchi. The veteran knows all the tricks in the book. She wrote some of the tricks in the book, Mei Yamaguchi. And she's got 1:55 remaining, but she has taken damage from the hands of Denice Zamboanga.
You can see that underhook is just pressing, driving that shoulder right into the chest of Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi's got to try to turn. She's got to try to get those underhooks and start spinning. Get her back away from the circle wall. Nice little knee there on the exit, but Zamboanga, you can see the way she's driving her head right into the face of Yamaguchi, keeping her pressed right up against that wall.
Right in front of our commentary position, 1:25 remains. Zamboanga full of confidence, and why not? It's been a superb performance from the young Filipina. Looks for the elbow on the inside. Yamaguchi still overhooking that right arm. Zamboanga keeps her pressed against the circle wall. Knee there from Zamboanga, the gut muncher. Still has her pressed against the wall here, Dragon. How does Yamaguchi get out of this and create an advantageous position?
She's got to try to frame off the head. She's got to try to get an underhook on that left side. She can't allow Zamboanga to turn her like that and keep her side pressed up against that. It's all about the head of Zamboanga, how she's driving her head right into the face and under the chin of Yamaguchi. Beautiful little short elbow there landed. Yamaguchi's trying to spin. She's trying to circle out to her left, but she can't because of the underhook of Zamboanga.
Knees to the midsection from Zamboanga. Time is ticking down here for Mei Yamaguchi. 25 seconds remains in the contest. Zamboanga again throws the left knee to the breadbasket.
Zamboanga's trying to take her right leg and slide it behind the legs of Mei Yamaguchi to possibly twist her into a takedown.
It looks like we're going to go to the judges for this one. Now Yamaguchi breaks off. Can she throw the overhand right? It's a final flurry from the veteran. Jab to right hand from Yamaguchi. The distance stop there.
Denice Zamboanga.